Hi friends, so today we're going to discuss about the introduction to CAM packages. So it comes under unit number 4, fundamentals of CNC and path programming. So before we jump into the CAM packages, we need to know about the introduction of the CNC machines. So first we do have NC machines called numerical codes. So where you have a tape, so those tapes has been punched with the programs. So those tapes will be read by the tape readers. So the punched tapes will be read by the tape readers, and it be sent to the NC code machines. So then later comes with the CNC machines, a computer numeric control. So where it has been assisted or aided with the help of computers to develop the program to manufacture a component. Then comes a direct numerical control, where you have a different sets of CNC machines which have been controlled by a central unit. We call it as a DNC. So now we're going to discuss about the different CAM software packages. So the CAM software is used to prepare the one for the production of a component. So it's like the end of the design process. So the advancement is in CAM software, so it includes you have an automatic robot. The program recognizes the feature automatically. So like holes, pocket and bosses and the few features that has been done on your CAD software, it recognizes automatically, and the appropriate program has been automatically generated. So it's been some advancement in CAM software packages. So there are three different basic CAM software packages you could classify. The first one, CAM software tool packages with CAD suits. So it means like an inbuilt. So we have a CAM software package built with some CAD softwares. So you do not have a separate CAD and separate CAM softwares. The second one called as a standalone CAM software. So you have a CAM software, only the CAM softwares. You do not have any other CAD associated with these CAM programs. The third one is plugin. So you can add the CAD softwares. So if you CAD softwares could be added to a few specific CAM softwares, so they do have some tie-up, so it's like a plugin. So let's go to the CAM packages. We have few CAM packages which is being listed here, so we do have a few more. As for some brief idea, I have given few sets of CAM packages. The first one, Bobcat CAM. So here it is like a plugin type of CAM package. So that is used to create the most complex shapes using the CAM software. Then also you can create the wire cut area. So you can create the wire path, so that has to travel towards the part to create a component, so through the wire cut. Next comes the CAM work. So here the CAM work is also a part of a plugin type of software. So it is actually has an advancement of automatic feature recognition. So it automatically scans, identifies the features and creates the machining programs. So next comes the CATIA, the computer aided three-dimensional interactive application, most often used to use in 3D modeling. So this is like an inbuilt CAM software package, where you do have a CAD software as well as the CAM software. So it has once you have an inbuilt, you don't need to, whenever you have changes in any 3D model, it automatically does in CAM processor. So it has a higher degree of associativity between the CAD design and the toolpath. If there is any change in CAD design, automatically the toolpath gets changed relatively. So the edge CAM. So edge CAM is a standalone package. It doesn't support any, it doesn't come with anything. So you can actually associate with some other CAD packages. It's a standalone. So it has been widely used. So it has some higher advantages. So it is user friendly. The workbench is user friendly. So. And it is used to access wide range of CAD files. So next comes the Fusion 360. So this is a package from the Autodesk. So it is a plugin, so comes with your Autodesk. So here it has an advancement of having an you could extend, you can import the files from the other CAD softwares and process the feature based machining parameters, and you could be able to get the GML code. So it's been offered by the Autodesk. So then comes with the Hypermill. Hypermill is also a plugin type software. So it is like a tailor made, so you can actually make your own requirement in order to build a CAM software package. So it's like a tailor made. You can access, you can contact and you can make your own, you can have your a specific type of a CAM package for your tool output. And then comes the MasterCAM. MasterCAM is the oldest CAM software package. It's been used since 1980s. So it is till now it has been famous because of its powerful CAM solutions. So whatever you change in the 3D model, so actually gets updated in your the CAM software, and it automatically generates the tool path and the G code. You will have to reprogram it from the scratch. So yes, you will have to reprogram from the scratch. Okay, so that's an advantage of having MasterCAM. The last one is a PowerMill. So PowerMill is also a plugin type. So it's been associated to few CAD software packages. So it has an advantage of having a feature recognition. The scans, identifies, and automatically creates the machining parameters. So it's been developed for particularly for mold dies and other complex parts. So there are a few CAM packages that is being used. So each package has its own advantage and disadvantage. So that's it. So thank you very much. If you have any doubts, you can post through the model. Thank you guys.